So what do you want to be when you get older, Sam?
You know what I want to be, a priest.
So what about being an engineer?
Nope, a priest.
But what about an artist?
Nope, a priest.
So if you're going to be a priest, what am I supposed to call you?
Father Sam.
Won't it be weird to have your mother call you father?
Not any weirder than Mary having to call Jesus the Savior of the world.
Good point. Now go clean your room.
But I want to be a priest.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Willits, and you're watching That Catholic Show. Everyone knows what a Catholic priest looks like, but there's more than meets the eye when it comes to the origins and purposes of the priesthood. The first letter of Timothy in the New Testament calls Jesus the one mediator between God and men. It is through Jesus that we are sanctified. It is through him that we are saved. After his death, resurrection, and ascension, he left us with men to administer the sacraments that he instituted, such as the Eucharist. That's why the Catechism teaches that Christ is the only true priest, the others being only his ministers. From the beginning of the Catholic Church over 2,000 years ago, the purpose of the priesthood is for the priest to act in persona Christi, meaning in the person of Christ. This is what Jesus wanted. He shows us this in Scripture when he chooses St. Peter to lead the Catholic Church when he said, "Thou art Peter, and upon this rock I shall build my church." St. Peter is considered the first pope of the Catholic Church. After Peter and the apostles, there have been more than 260 popes and countless bishops following an unbroken line back to the first apostles. And the bishops have then ordained countless priests to do Christ's work with them here on earth. Bishops, priests, popes, these are basically the titles used since the second century to present the offices established in the New Testament. As early as 110 AD, St. Ignatius of Antioch, one of the early church fathers, stated, "Take care to do all things in harmony with God, with the bishop presiding in the place of God, and with the presbyters in the place of the council of the apostles." The priesthood isn't a career that you just stumble into. It's more than a job. It's a vocation. It's a calling from God. That Catholic Show, how may I direct your call? As one of the seven sacraments, Roman Catholic and Eastern Orthodox churches limit the ordination of priests to men. Even though his mother would have been an obvious choice, it was Jesus himself who chose only men, and the church continues that practice today. Paragraph 1565 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church states that through the sacrament of holy orders, priests share in the universal dimensions of the mission that Christ entrusted to the apostles. Furthermore, the Catechism teaches that all priests who are constituted in the order of priesthood by the sacrament of the order are bound together by an intimate sacramental brotherhood, but in a special way, they form one priestly body in the diocese to which they are attached under their own bishop. It is the bishop in his role as a successor to the apostles who is following the apostolic succession established by Christ when he ordains priests during the rite of ordination. The bishop ordains his priests and anoints their hands because it is with these hands that they bring forth the sacraments to the church. Once ordained, it is to these leaders that we trust our spiritual care. They bring us the sacraments that help us grow in our faith. They are our spiritual fathers who help lead us to our Father in heaven. Thanks for watching That Catholic Show. I'm Jennifer Willits. See you next time. Father, may I have your blessing.
Jennifer, the Lord be with you.
SQPN, the best in Catholic podcasting.
Sacraments such as the, forgot the line, ascension. He left us, I keep fit with the thick with men to administer the sacraments. I'm so sorry.
true priest, the others being merely and only, exclusively, his ministers. Oh, so sorry, we're just filming a little scene right here. Okay, that's what it looks like when I go through a spider web. Bishops, priests, popes, these are basically the titles. Back in the New Testament. I butchered it, I know. As early as 110 AD, St. Ignatius of Antioch. He's one of the early church fathers, stated, voiceover, voiceover, voiceover.